A blessed morning, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to Carmelite Monastery. We are now on the 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We also offer this Mass to all teachers in celebration of the World Teachers' Day. Let me read to you this circular letter number 2021, that's 021, from the Roman Catholic Bishop of Bacolod. Greetings. October 5, 2021 is National Teachers' Day. The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines, upon the request of the Metrobank Foundation, has endorsed that all the churches and parishes in every diocese or archdiocese of the Philippines are to recite a prayer for teachers during the anticipated and Sunday Masses on October 2 and 3, 2021, respectively. With my prayers and pastoral blessing, Patricio A. Buzon, SDP DD, Bishop of Bacolod, by order of His Excellency, Reverend Father Roy Christian Yusulgon, Chancellor, Secretary. Please all kneel for the National Prayer for Teachers. Giver of all wisdom and greatest of all teachers, look upon our teachers with love. Grant them that resolve to nurture our eager minds and to never give up on us who fall behind. Bless their hearts, for they rejoice when we succeed and encourage us when we fail. Endow them with gentle patience, for the path of learning is never easy. Kindle a spirit of passion in them. It is the flame that ignites the love of learning in us. Help them see the potential in each student. Their belief in us means much more than the grade we make. Instill in them a commitment to keep on learning. It shows us not to fear new knowledge and experiences. Inspire them to touch the future. They influence how big a dream we dream for ourselves. Bless our teachers who have come before, for their work endures to this day. Let the light of your example shine upon all teachers, to build up with their words, to love with their mind, to share with their heart. Amen. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters, the institution of marriage has always been under attack. Entering a marriage when either or both partners are ill prepared does not help the resulting union. The pressures of modern living further weaken it. Many no longer consider marriage as a lifetime commitment. Question about divorce. Jesus points to the beginning of creation and declares that what God has joined together, no human being must separate. May the Eucharist unite married couples more intimately with Christ, that they may witness to God's faithful love for His church. Let us now rise and welcome our Lord Jesus Christ in the person of His minister, Reverend Father Roy Christian Yusulgon.
Celebrate. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth.
Glory to God in the highest, and on
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. God made man and woman for each other, and in marriage made the two of them one. In the Gospel, Jesus refers to this original will of God in prohibiting divorce. The first reading.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God casts a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them became one flesh." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. By becoming man and experiencing the bitterness of death, Jesus becomes a brother to men and women and brings them back to the love of God. The second reading.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Sisters and brothers, he for a little while was made known lower than the angels, that by the grace of God, that he might taste the death for everyone. For it was fitting that he, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the leader to their salvation perfect through suffering. He who consecrates and those who are being consecrated all have one origin. Therefore, he is not ashamed to call them brothers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all rise.
If we love one another, God remains in us, and the love is brought to perfection in us.
Spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees approached Jesus and asked, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." And people were bringing children to them that he might touch them, but the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced them and blessed them, placing his hands on them. My dear friends, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters in Christ. Our Lord has very strong words on this very controversial topic, and that is our point of reflection for this morning, the law on divorce. And there is an existing bill right now in Congress talking about this. A lot of discussions have been happening about divorce. And in the Philippines, we hold on to the belief that marriage is a social institution and as such should be protected by the state. And as far as the church is concerned, marriage is not simply a contract. Marriage is a sacrament. And so, given these points, our point of departure is actually the gospel for today, the very words of Jesus. The context of our gospel is a testing of Jesus' position on the matter. The Pharisees wanted to test him, and that is a detail that is given to us by the Gospel of Mark. We read from the Gospel, the Pharisees approach Jesus and ask, is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife? And Mark gives us an important description of the reason behind this question. They were testing him. How many times we also want to test certain established laws? How many times we also want to push further the boundaries of things? How many times we want to explore other possibilities? And most of the discussions are on this matter. We test how far we can go, how far we can push things. And Jesus knows precisely the intent of the Pharisees, and so he asked them for purposes of discussion. Kanam kay Jesus, no? Wala siya dahil gapang, ano na, tawag. Hindi ko kaano sang ilong ko. Gapang tapal. Jesus wants us and even his adversaries to reflect further. No? And that only shows how Jesus also is respectful at times of other perspectives. But not simply respect as to tolerate it, but respect in a sense that it becomes an invitation for further clarification, for further discussion. And so Jesus gave them a question. What did Moses command you? Beautiful, no? There are established orders, but we don't simply stop at established orders, but we go into the origin of that established order. We go into the reason why, and that is what is important. Because at times we can simply stop at the text, but we don't deepen our understanding that text has a context. At times we simply stop at laws and the established order, but we don't ask the question, how come in the first place there is such a law? Or how come in the first place there is such an established order? And so Jesus invites his adversaries to go into the origin of things. Because as we move towards the origin of things, we can see why it was there in the first place. Hindi ko mag-diagnosis kita, gani, maski na doktor, wala na nag-settle sa mga simptoma, hindi bala? Sakit ulo ya, galupot siya, o wala siya kusog. Ang doktor, wala man na yan, nag-solve sa imo problema, nga lupot, lingin ulo, wala kusog. Kundi ka pa man ko itong doktor, nga may amuni nga mga simptoma, di ini nagahalin na tikanami. And so Jesus is not simply about the symptoms, but Jesus wants to go into the cause, the origin. Beautiful. And then he gives the truth from the response of the Pharisees. Ano hambal niya? Hambal sa mga Pharisees. Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her. But Jesus told them, because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning,
beautiful. That's the bombshell. From the beginning, the origin of things is this. When these were created, then we go back to the first reading from the book of Genesis. That is the context. The why of things. Wala lang tayo nag-settle sa mga the what, the how, no? But nag-settle kita, yeah, as Christians, we explore the why of things. That is the invitation of Jesus. Why? And Jesus gives us the answer. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate. And that is, I believe, a direct quotation from our first reading from the book of Genesis. My dear friends, the whys of things, the origin, the reason for being, that is what Jesus is interested on. Not simply the accidents, but he wants to go into the substance, the core of the issue. Yung isa kadamo na sa mga inapang discuss, etc. Pero wala ta nagabalik sa pinaka. Di, para masulbar ang lingin sang ulo, masulbar ang lupot, masulbar ang wala sang kusog, mangkuton, ano gid bala ang problema mo? We don't simply address the symptoms, but we address the real problem. And so, my dear friends, purpose, the creation of things, that is our foundation in the beginning. In this Gospel of Mark, it is good that at times laws are simply expressions also of what we want, but it should not stop there. Laws must be founded on something deeper, the nature of things. Kung kisa ginabalik na ito ng mga layi, hindi na nami. Because the laws in the first place should be over and above us. It should be over and above us. We don't use the law for our personal interest. Because no one should be above the law. It is the law that should be above us all. And the laws, according to St. Thomas Aquinas, are expressions of the mind of God. And the origins of the law is this, that all laws have only one origin, and that is the divine law. Yung muna yung kasimple kay Aquinas. Human laws will find its basis on divine law. Natural law should find its foundation on divine law. When there's a problem with inconsistencies between the mind of God and human laws, then something happens. Something is wrong. Amula na ikasimple ang framework ni Thomas Aquinas. Di maskin anon mo pa, masiling ka, wala gravity. Wala ko gapati sa gravity. Of course, with science, we also say, we defy gravity, right? But by defying gravity, doesn't mean that we totally eliminate gravity. Di ba la? Pope Benedict XVI has a very good reflection on laws. In one of his book, he was dealing with the problem of abortion and about life, and he says, primordial to all laws is the law of life. And according to Benedict XVI, law on life is already there even before the states were. So what do you do with those laws? You simply recognize them. You don't create them. You simply recognize them. Dido mantay ako kay Isaiah, man is the creator of laws. May mga bagay nga, innate laws are already existent. You simply recognize them. You don't create them. Ang natural laws, ang gravity, ikaw nag-create. Ingaan mo lang na iangalan, di ba la? Sakto. Ang preeminence of the right to life, you don't create it. Maski hindi na siya i-recognize sa isang state, ara na siya iya. You don't create. You simply recognize what is already there. My dear friends, the origin of things in the beginning. This is a good reflection as we move towards the end of the gospel, because according to Jesus, part of accepting God's kingdom is actually accepting His will for us. And thus, the image that Jesus brings to the fore, He brings the discussion to this experience of little children. To be under God's laws, to be under the will of God, to be admitted to the kingdom of God means that one is to submit to the will of God. When Jesus saw His disciples parrying children to come before Him, He said, "Let the children come to Me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." To accept the kingdom means to be like little children, submitting ourselves to the will of God. Saint Paul has a very contentious verse in relation to marriage, and that is found in Ephesians chapter 5 verse 22, when he says, "Wives, submit yourselves to your husband." But let us not forget, when you move further into verse 25, husbands are given these indications. Husbands, love your wife as Christ loves His church and as He offered Himself for her to make her holy. Beautiful. Submission of the wife to the husband. But take note, the husband is to give himself fully to his wife as Christ loves His church. Ikanami. To submit also connotes the reciprocal action of giving oneself fully. Unless you become like little children, you will not enter the kingdom of God. Submission to the will of God means following also God's commandments. Tikanami, there's another part of scripture, this time from the Gospel of John, chapter 15, verse 9. "Remain in Me as I in the Father. You remain in Me by following the commandments." to be part of the kingdom is to remain in God. And to remain in God is submission to the will of God, and that is expressed in following the commandments. My dear friends, we always go back to the why of things, to the reason for being of things. We don't simply look at the symptoms, but we look at the core. And at the core of the issue is a question of commitment, a question of submission, a question of allowing oneself to be under the order of God for things. When we enter a game, we don't change the rules of the game while engaging in the game. Hindi ba? Kaya ito naglain ang lagan sa hampang tati, change na dayon ang rules. Ang rules bala is over and above the game, the gamers. Hindi ba? Tiyan mo na kung kaisa masingkat. Though hindi naman siya favorable sa ako ni change na niya. No? Of course, we don't justify domestic abuse. We don't justify abusive husbands. They will be held accountable before the law of God, because the law of God is over and above us. So my dear friends, as we reflect further on this, let us look at Jesus. Jesus who challenges our paradigms. A Jesus who continually goes back to the will of the Father, because that is the basis by which he does all of these things. What is the purpose of God for marriage? What is the purpose of God for our families? What is the purpose of God for our human experience of commitments? That is where we should be asking the real questions. May God bless our families. May God bless our couples. May God bless the institution of marriage. Amen. We rise. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My dear friends, the Father, you raise marriage and family life into a living sacrament of your life and love. We pray to you that the bonds of love may grow stronger in and among us. In trust we pray. Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May church leaders continue to guide married couples and their families with listening and understanding hearts, just as Jesus did. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May those who are in public office create programs that help families develop mutual love and understanding without compromising human dignity. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May the leaders of our nation speak out bravely against evil, that destroys the dignity of human person and conservation of the world, we pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May married couples who are having difficulties in their relationships be able to reach out to each other so that they may grow in faithfulness and love. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May all those who are suffering for the sake of gospel find hope and healing in the loving care of Jesus. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
May the dead attain the eternal vision of heaven so that they may gain the future resurrection. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord of love, hear our prayer. Loving Father, strengthen the bonds of love that keep us together as one family in Christ. May this love be manifested in our words and deeds. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all this holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For you laid the foundations of the world, and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
indeed, holy O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For my Lord rose at resurrection.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Patricio, our Bishop, Vicente, Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, especially the soul of Father Mike Carrion, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Our Lady of Mount Carmel, with Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calongsod, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, Saint John of the Cross, all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now call upon God, our Father.
Come, thy will be done on earth as it is.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, and said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ.
Amen.
Mother's child, it takes thy hand to
Please all rise.
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please all kneel for the mission prayer. God, our loving Father, you sent your Son into the world to proclaim the good news of salvation to all, to sinners, the poor, oppressed, the sick, the abandoned and neglected. He gave his life on the cross for us and rose again to new life, to redeem us and reconcile us with you. You sent your Holy Spirit to the apostles to continue the work of your Son and to lead all to salvation. We thank you, Father, for bringing us from darkness into light through your loving plan 500 years ago. Missionaries came to our land to proclaim the gospel of Jesus, your Son, to our ancestors that made us your people and the church. The gift of faith has accompanied us through both darkness and lights, defeats and victories of our history as your people. Our faith has become for us true light that shines in the darkness. Renew in us the grace of your Spirit that impels us to be witnesses of Jesus, your Son, to a world broken by greed, violence, injustice, sickness, and suffering. May our faith bring us to unity as your children, to care for and love one another. May the Holy Spirit empower us to be proclaimers of the good news to our brothers and sisters in Asia and to all nations. Give us the sincere desire to help others to come to faith in the Lord Jesus, to share in your joy and life. May the Blessed Mother, the star of evangelization, accompany us and pray for us as we live and share our faith with others. May our strong love and devotion to her as our Mahal na Ina form us to be true disciples and witnesses of Jesus to all, always ready to be sent and to be obedient to whatever Jesus asks of us. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please all rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your loved ones, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharist has been offered. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.